Brain wave propagation in different media, lossless media, lossy media, and conductor media. The question now is, we have electric and magnetic field. What will be the stored electric energy and what will be the power flow of such electromagnetic waves? To answer these two questions, we say that the time average stored energy in electric field inside the volume V is defined as WE, the stored electric energy is WE, is 1 over 4 real, the integration of E dot D conjugate. And since D is related to E as epsilon E, so we can say that E dot epsilon E conjugate. And any vector multiplied by dot product of the same vector conjugate, so in this case, this is the modulus of the electric field squared. So in this case, the stored electric energy in electric field is epsilon over 4 is the integration over the volume E dot E conjugate integrated with respect to the volume. In a similar way, the time average magnetic energy stored in a volume V, Wm, is 1 over 4 real the integration of the magnetic field H dot the magnetic flux density B conjugate dV. And because the magnetic flux is related to the magnetic field as B equal mu H, so in this case the stored magnetic energy would be mu over 4 the integration over the volume H dot H conjugate dV. And as we mentioned, any vector dot H conjugate is the modulus of this vector squared. This is the average or time average stored energy. Now we are going to talk about Poynting theory, which relate the power flow due to electromagnetic waves. Assuming that we have finite volume V, and this finite volume is surrounded by a closed surface S, and inside this volume we have sources for electric and magnetic current, J source and M source, and these sources introduces electric and magnetic fields inside this volume. And assuming that this volume has a material which has parameter mu, epsilon, and sigma, so the electric and magnetic field inside this volume are related by Maxwell's equation as curl E equals minus J omega mu H minus M, and curl H would be J omega epsilon E plus J. To find out the radiated power and the dissipated power and the stored energy inside this volume, we start with multiplying the first equation by the magnetic field as a dot product. So multiplying the first equation by H conjugate by dot product, we can obtain that is minus J omega mu H conjugate dot H. So it is H squared minus H conjugate dot M. And M inside the volume is only the magnetic current source MS. On the other hand, if you multiply the second equation by the electric field as a dot product and represent the magnetic field by its conjugate, so all this equation would be conjugate. So in this case, it would be E dot curl H conjugate equals J omega epsilon E dot E conjugate. E dot E conjugate is effectively E square. And because epsilon here can be complex quantity, so epsilon B conjugate. So it would be J omega epsilon conjugate E square. Plus E dot J conjugate. The electric current density in this case can be decomposed in two parts. One part is the source and the other part is due to sigma multiplied by the electric field, where sigma is the conductivity of the medium multiplied by the electric field induced in the medium. So effectively the current in this case is Js, the source current, and sigma E. Sigma E dot E conjugate, or sigma E conjugate dot E, it would be sigma E square. Also, because we are taking the conjugate, J omega epsilon would be minus J omega. So it would be minus J because of the conjugate. So this is the reason of minus J here. Okay. Assuming that we are taking the divergence of E cross H conjugate. The divergence of E cross H conjugate, it can be simplified as H conjugate dot curl E minus E dot curl H conjugate, which are these two terms. So the divergence of E cross H conjugate would be this term minus this term. So this term is minus J omega mu H minus G omega mu H squared minus H conjugate dot M source minus H conjugate dot M source minus this term. So this would be minus E dot G source minus E dot J source minus sigma E squared minus sigma E squared plus J omega epsilon conjugate E squared plus J omega epsilon conjugate E squared. So this is the divergence of E cross H conjugate. Now, by using the divergence theorem states that the integration over the volume of the divergence of any field equals the integration over the closed surface, which is surrounding this volume, of this field dot ds. So, by taking the integration over the volume for this side and this side and replace the integration over the volume here by the integration over the closed surface by using the divergence theory, we can prove that the integration over the closed surface E equals H conjugate dot ds would equal minus sigma, the integration over the volume E square dV, plus J omega, the integration over the volume epsilon E squared minus mu H squared dV, minus the integration over the volume E dot J surface conjugate plus H conjugate dot M surface or M source, sorry, J source and M source dV. Effectively, this term corresponds to the power from the source. The power delivered from the source is the integration over the volume, the electric field, the induced electric field, dot the source current conjugate, plus the magnetic field conjugate, dot M source dV. So this would be the power delivered from the source. So we are going to make this in one side and multiply it by half, because we are talking about the root mean square values. So in the root mean square values, we need 1 over 2. 1 over 2 is this integration, which corresponds to the power coming from the current source, either the electric current source or magnetic current source. Okay? So this in one side. Let us move the other terms, this term and this term, to the side of this term. So, and remember that we multiplied by 1 over 2. So 1 over 2, the integration over the closed surface E cross H conjugate to ds, plus, we move this to the other side, plus sigma over 2 E squared dV. And here we have minus J omega over 2, this integration in this side. Before moving this integration, let us remember that epsilon and mu are complex quantities, such that epsilon, it can be represented as epsilon dash minus j epsilon double dashes. And similarly, mu, it can be represented as mu dash minus j mu double dash. So epsilon conjugate is actually epsilon dash plus j epsilon double dash. Right? So, if we have the imaginary part j epsilon double dash multiplied by j, it would be minus omega epsilon double dash. And the real part, it would be j omega epsilon dash. So, we are going to move this term to the other side and divide it by 2. And separate the real part and imaginary part. So in this case, it would be the imaginary part would be omega over 2 epsilon double dash E squared plus omega over 2 mu double dash H squared dV. Regarding to the real part of epsilon dash and mu dash, it would be J omega epsilon dash, and we have negative sign here, so minus J omega over 2 epsilon dash E squared. Here we have negative sign, so in the other side would be positive, so it would be J omega over 2 mu dash H squared D. Now the left hand side correspond to the power from the source. This term corresponds to the dissipated power due to the conductivity of the medium inside the body. This term corresponds to the dissipated power due to epsilon double dash. And this term corresponds to the dissipated power due to mu double dash. Finally, these two terms correspond to the stored magnetic energy and stored electric energy. So, in general, we can represent this equation in this form, such that the first term here corresponds to the power of the source, complex power source delivered by the sources, G source and M source, inside the closed surface S. The vector E cross H conjugate, we are going to call it S, and this is the pointing vector. Let us talk about the pointing vector and B naught later, but as the first, sigma over 2, the integration over E squared dV, is the power dissipated in the finite conductivity of the medium. And omega over 2 epsilon double dash E squared is the dissipated energy due to the imaginary part of the permittivity. And mu double dash H squared multiplied by omega over 2 is the dissipated energy due to the imaginary part of the permeability. So, this term, which consists of this term and this term, correspond to the power losses. So, this is the time average power dissipated in the volume V due to the conductivity, the dielectric and magnetic losses. The final term here is the stored electric and magnetic energy. So this is effectively 2J omega multiplied by the magnetic stored energy minus the electric stored energy. And as we mentioned, the stored magnetic energy is omega over 4, so by multiplying it by 2, it would be J omega over 2 mu dash H squared. And similarly, the stored electric energy, it was omega over 4 epsilon dash E squared, so by multiplying it by 2J, it would be J omega over 2 epsilon dash E squared. So, this term corresponds to the stored electric and magnetic energy. So, the first term is the power from the source. These two terms correspond to the dissipated power inside the volume. This term corresponds to the stored electric and magnetic energy inside the volume. So, the remaining term, which corresponds to half the integration over the closed surface E cross H conjugate, is effectively the power flow from this closed surface. So, in this case, we have power coming from the source. Some of them is dissipated in the sigma. Some of them is dissipated in epsilon double dash. Some of them is dissipated in mu double dash. Some of them is stored as a stored energy inside this volume. And some of them is going outside or moving outside this surface. So, effectively, B naught represents the complex power flow out of the closed surface. And the pointing vector in this case represents the power density going outside the surface. So, the output power or the output power flow from this closed surface is half the integration over the closed surface of the pointing vector dot ds. So, E cross or half E cross H conjugate is the power density flowing, power density with respect to the surface, flowing from the surface. This actually is known as the pointing theorem, and the pointing theorem states that the power coming from the source equal the power flow from the surface plus the power dissipated inside this surface plus the stored energy inside this surface. This is known as Poynting theorem. Okay.